Ordinary matter.
Is dark matter some other kind of particle that we just haven't detected, haven't found yet?
The answer must lie at the intersection of particle physics and astronomy. Peter Fisher was one of the first to bring particle physics to the dark matter problem.
Finding out what dark matter is has been something that's really driven more by particle physics than by astronomers.
For decades, physicists like Peter have focused on a theoretical particle called a WIMP.
Weakly interacting massive particle, or WIMP. I think there was a lot of work that went into finding that acronym.
In order to create the kind of gravity that draws large amounts of matter together, the particle would need to have mass. But because it's invisible and eludes detection, it also must be weakly interacting.
So I think of dark matter as kind of ghosts. We don't see them because they just don't interact very often. What that means is that a WIMP could pass right through the Earth without hitting any of the atoms in the Earth. In fact, if you lined up 100 billion Earths, a WIMP would go right through.
So how do you capture such an elusive particle? Peter Fisher spent 20 years building machine after machine attempting to do just that.
My students, postdocs, and I built hundreds of these different experiments. Hundreds. There's the remnants of three sitting right here. This is really kind of a mess. Every experiment we build is bigger and more complicated.
And with each generation, the experiments not only got larger and more complex, they went further underground. The hunt for WIMPs brought particle physicist Ken Clark here to this mine in Canada.
We've tried to detect them in a much more physical way. We're actually looking for this dark matter to interact. And that's why most of the major dark matter experiments right now are trying to do.
There are four different experiments at Snow Lab. At 6,800 feet underground, it is one of the deepest labs in the world. It has to be.
All the time, all around us, there's cosmic rays and there's particles that are streaming in through the Earth's atmosphere and that kind of thing. And if we were to set up our experiments here on the surface, we would be completely swamped by those signals.
Instead, the experiments are brought here, a mile underground, into special caverns blasted out of the bedrock. Waiting for a bubble. But they haven't found a WIMP yet.
So far, this one has detected exactly zero dark matter particles, but we're hopeful that the next generation we're going to actually see something in it.
Back at MIT, it's a familiar story for Peter Fisher.
In hundreds of experiments, we've never seen what we know to be a WIMP. I've been doing this for 35 years, and so you might think that, you know, not having detected a WIMP, I would be frustrated by that. Maybe a little bit, but as a scientist, what's exciting is building something and seeing it work. Someday, these ideas might really shape how we think of ourselves as living beings.